It all starts with Destiny's Child. I've been in Destiny's Child since I was 9, over half of my life, and that is my life. That's my heart, my love, and we've all grown together. And I know since this time we had doing solo projects, we really had to grow because we depend on each other so much. First time I say no. The name of my album is Dangerously in Love. And actually, I wrote the song about, what is it, 3 years ago? I always liked that title because sometimes when you fall in love, it's a little dangerous. Because I'm a young lady, basically evolving into a young woman now. I thought that was a great title because there's so many steps in relationships and love, and that's what the album is about. Certainly you can call me, baby. I'd love to hear from you. Yes, of course, you can come and see me, boy. Wanna get to know you more. Sure, I'm feeling you. No, baby, not yet. We can't take that next step. Why you getting so upset, boy? You act as though I never told you yes before. For this album, I wanted to collaborate because I wanted to grow. And I feel like I'm always looking for a way to grow. And I didn't want to do it by myself because I wanted to go to the next level. So for the majority of this record, I wrote in the studio with the other producers. Sometimes different concepts, because I love to come up with concepts. I usually get that from just sitting down talking to people and seeing what people go through and seeing what people want to hear songs about.
This was my self-portrait. This is what he drew me. Drew of me.
I was trying. My art game is on zero.
Oh, look, it got Pepsi on it. That was his portrait. I drew him.
That's me. I'm a star. I'm a star now. She drawing pictures.
The first person I worked with was Scott Storch. And when I first met Scott, we just clicked. He was just a very humble person. And I was already a fan of his production, but I was looking for people that I vibe with well and our personalities worked well so we can make great music, and that's what happened. His beats were really different, didn't sound like anything else, and I wrote with him in ES. We did Naughty Girl first. That was the first song I recorded. If I sing a little melody up under you saying that that's how you like it, huh?
It will make it fuller. Makes sense.
When I first heard That's How You Like It, I loved it. And basically the song talks about all the things in a relationship you like, all of the characteristics in a man that you like. And it just, it's really happy. It's, you know, just a feel good song. That's how you like it, huh? That's how I like it, baby. That's how you like it, huh? That's how you like it, huh? How you like it, huh? That's how you like it, huh? That's how you like it, huh? Let me get the second and third one over. Crazy Right Now is, I guess you would say, the first step of a relationship when you are still kind of, it's right before you let go and you're still conscious of the things that you're doing and you're like, God, I'm looking crazy. I'm playing myself. I'm doing things that I would never do, you know, but you kind of don't care because you're falling in love with him. His love just got you bugging. The beat in my heart is when I'm with you, but I still don't do the same. Just how you love me, do I know what else can? Got me looking so crazy right now. Your love's got me looking so crazy right now. Which side is best for me? Capricorn, Aquarius, Pisces, Aries, Taurus, Gemini, Cancer. Signs was a song Missy played for me in the studio, and it talked about everyone's zodiac sign and basically the characteristics of each sign. And we sat down and talked about, you know, different people that I know and different things that have happened and different, you know, qualities and different signs that I've experienced, and we put it in the song. Fanatic sent me the track to Speechless, and it had a whole Isley Brothers just love making sound. It was really slow and really sexy and really sensual, and I've never done a song like that. Off, I want to be around the ocean because I feel like the ocean is God's peace. Whenever you're hectic and crazy and just too much, I just like to go to the water and listen to the waves and feel the sun. That's why I recorded a lot of my album in Miami. Yeah.
certified quality. Quality. Not the girl I'm needing to cry for every day without apology. Hey. What them the right
yo,
way
yo, yo,
the
yo, right yo. 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 All right then.
After I finished Baby Boy, I thought this would be perfect if Sean Paul was on. That's what's missing. So we called him, I talked to him, he was in Jamaica. We talked on the phone and he was really nice and really excited. His accent was crazy, I loved it. Then he flew to Miami and we worked on the song. When I first met him, he was really, really just calm and just a nice person. You could feel his aura, he was just really humble and he was excited about it and he went in the studio and he killed it. It turned out great.
The way my step, the way my make my stride, so follow your feeling, baby girl, because they cannot be denied. Check me in at the night to make we get it amplified. Well, equipped for met the ship, me now go slip, me now go slide. In other words, the love I got to give is certified. For giving the longest, toughest type of ride, girl. The love I got to give is certified. For giving the toughest, longest type of ride, girl.
Baby boy, you stay on my mind.
I thought Me, Myself, and I was a great song for women because in relationships, it's not always good, it's not always great, it's not always smooth. Sometimes the guy disappoints you and then most women look back and they're thinking, God, I'm smarter than that. What was I thinking? You know, I should have known what he was talking about. All that BS he was talking, I should have known. But the way I looked at it was you just take that experience and, you know, just think of it as a growing experience. And you always have yourself and you can always depend on yourself. You won't ever disappoint yourself. So it's basically a celebration of a breakup.
That's what I found out, and it ain't no need to cry. I took a vow that from now on I'm gonna be my own best friend. Me, myself, and I, that's all I got in the end. That's what I found out, and it ain't no need to cry. I took a vow that from now on I'm gonna be my own best friend. I'd be myself and I know that I will never disappoint myself.
I hope you enjoyed my album, Dangerously in Love. I did it for y'all, and hopefully y'all can fall in love while listening to it. Maybe make some babies. No. Don't put that in there. Hopefully you can fall in love while listening to it and hear some great music. All right. Goodbye.